Welcome to our weekend cookout. At least I think it's the weekend. I seem to be having trouble with my internal calendar. Here at Hemlock Holmes Golf Club, we want to provide a family experience. So we're holding a community cookout for all the nearby families. It just really rusts my actuators that I don't have any meat to grill. Could you get me some Radstag meat? If you could also find Yaoguai meat and Deathclaw meat, I'll be able to make some exotic steaks. You appear to be a few steaks short.
fugitive is attempting to evade capture. Beginning pursuit. Warning, dangerous fugitive is on the loose. Do not attempt to apprehend.
is grumpy. That's why he has hammers.
Too fun.
Someone there?
Thank you.
must have been nothing.
wish just once we could keep it together. Alright, 10 seconds to take a breather.
My wife's throwing another party, isn't she? Well, enjoy the festivities.
How would things be different with a normal family?
Stay awake to hear it!
Excuse me? Just who do you think you're speaking to?
Oh, shut it, Connie. You're always starting crap.
I got the right to say what I mean. Your fancy jazz is putting me to sleep.
Really? Now I don't know what indignities you and this country thrift store are forced to survive out here.
Hey! I scavenged these threads from Charleston landfill, fair and square.
You're living in a bubble, lady. The wasteland ain't no place for some schnazzy pre-war nightclub.
Get out of my club! Get out! Out!
Whoa, jeez Louise. You don't have to tell me twice.
By the way, your singing sucks anyway.
Oh, the nerve!
Well, that was embarrassing. Welcome to the Rose Room. Anything to drink?
Don't mind me.
Can I do something for you?
Do this, do that.
Pleased to make your acquaintance.
What's your pleasure? I apologize on behalf of my mother. We'll have enough trouble getting people in here without her immediately scaring them away. To be honest, this is more turnout than I expected. Which is welcome, of course. I mean, I just hope the rest of them are friendly. Anything to drink? Yeah, well, I've got more of them than I'd like. Sorry, it's not your job to hear me complain. It's your job to relax, have a drink, and enjoy the music. So, what can I help you with? There's another question for my dear mother. We just moved here from the coast, Atlantic City, which, believe it or not, is doing pretty well compared to, you know, everywhere else. Over there, Mom was an entertainer. It's what she does, what she knows. I don't think she's woken up to the reality of what the rest of the world is like out here. My sister's sitting over there. Dad's probably up in his room. He's getting up there, starting to have some cognitive issues recently. It doesn't make him great for socializing. See, that's, you know, why does anyone move, really? To see new sights, you know, make new friends, get a fresh start. Could I offer you another drink? Yeah. Yeah, I really could. My mom thought we weren't going to have any trouble tonight, but the crowd I've seen so far, I have my doubts. Big ones. If you feel inclined, could you keep an eye out? Maybe, if it's necessary, handle a fight? But keep a low profile about it so Mom doesn't freak out. I'd really appreciate it. Really? You mean it? Go ahead and join the audience. If nothing happens, then, you can enjoy the show just like everyone else. I hope that's the case, but, you know, better safe than sorry. And thank you. I do really appreciate the help. You need something too?
Looking bunch out there. Well, as I say, there's no better cure for a long day than some snazzy tunes. Sit back and enjoy.
I can't listen to this baloney no more. Let's light this place up.
God damn it! Everyone, stop! You see me give the goddamn signal!
How hard is it to follow simple instructions?
They're gonna come for me. Enzo, why is my audience dead?
Why don't you ask this guy before he croaks?
I mean, really? What does on my signal mean to you? Does it mean whatever the hell you want? Didn't turn out well for them. What about me, huh? Condemned to death by the stupidity of others. It was simple. Wait for all the Russos to be in the room together. Shoot on my signal. Couldn't follow either one. Almost makes me happy to be put out of my freaking misery.
Vincenzo, what did you do?
What? Really? You of all people are gonna point your finger at me?
Guess every one of you nutsos has a reason to be afraid of payback from Atlantic City. Sleep tight, Russos. I may not be the last to come for you.
Just nonsense is all it is. We can't let them scare us.
We don't know who they are to begin with.
Oh, don't act like you're above all this. For all we know, someone at City Hall has it out for you.
I can't even begin to tell you how little you know about me and City... Shit, Abby.
What was that?
Are you okay?
Get away from me! Oh, they know. I thought I covered my tracks. They're gonna come back. They're gonna...
What are you talking about?
She's got the shakes. Could be she's danced with the devil. You're my own mom. Don't talk to me like...
Crap. I think you're right.
Those who'd fancy themselves part of the Atlantic City high life have access to a special intoxicant. They drink the devil's blood. I should have paid more attention. Must be the stress of the move got to her.
You say that now. All of this was your idea. We're so busy dealing with your problems, there's no room for anyone else.
Is that really how you feel, Vincenzo?
Yes, it is 100% absolutely how I feel.
After everything I've done for us, everything I've sacrificed, unbelievable.
Crap. I think I went too far. Sorry about all this. I was right to expect trouble, just not this much of it. Just, please go talk to my mother for me. It was a bad time to set her off. Right now, we just need to figure out how to help Abby.
Must have left something. Where did I screw up?
Thank you. I know you'll have better luck than I would.
What was that? Must have left something. Where did I screw up? Opening night is a failure. I offer drinks, games, music, more excitement and luxury than this dreary mountain range has ever seen. And what do I get? An audience full of hitmen, a strung-out daughter, and an unappreciative son. Just ridiculous. Nothing makes sense anymore! I'm so cold. Need me! The last time they needed me was when they were in diapers. Those unruly children learned the gift of language and have used it to complain ever since. Welcome to my life. Nothing has gone right since the bombs, and that's a damn long time to make the show go on. What was that? Of course he does. And I'd like one thing in the last 20 years of my life to count as a success. Is that so much to ask for? Oh, fine. I'll come downstairs and help. The extra moment of peace isn't worth delaying the inevitable. But it's not like I'll be able to do anything anyway. Once a paradise, now a madhouse. Everyone lost their sanity after the bombs. The showmen are the worst of all. Avoid them at all costs. Must have left something. Where did I screw up? They're masochists who get off on risking their own lives in front of others. Once upon a time, people could appreciate simple talent. Now, everyone's so depressed about the end of the world that the only way they can feel something is by pumping their adrenaline up to 11. The showmen make a living by capitalizing on that desire. You think I'm not concerned? Let me ask you something. What do you do to de-stress? Read a comic? Listen to the radio? It's the apocalypse. Maybe you go out and blow some heads off. Whatever it is,
what was that?
It's a distraction. A tool to stay sane under pressure. So don't you dare judge me for keeping my head above water. Much better to complain than to have an emotional breakdown. What are you implying? know anything about me. I did what was necessary to survive in a cutthroat industry full of insane people. If they come after me for that, let them. Do me one favor first. Go upstairs and let my husband Antonio know what's happening. He may not understand, but he should at least be told.
Well, pleasure to meet you. Welcome to the Russo's Haven. How do you like the festivities? Blood of the devil? Now, that doesn't sound like something anybody should be drinking.
Must have left something. Where did I screw up?
My daughter. Oh, yeah. She's a great kid. Fast learner. Resilient. And stubborn. Does she need something?
What was that?
My daughter. I still remember catching little Abby with a pack of candy pilfered from the convenience store. So clever. Yeah, and so stubborn. I never thought that she would, were we talking about somebody? Going already? But you just said hello.
Gonna come for me.
You're back. Thanks for that. Look, I've done some thinking. Devil's blood is highly addictive, and withdrawal is dangerous. It could even be fatal. We're hundreds of miles away from anyone who knows what to do about this. Doctors here are only going to know about regular chems.
A doctor's not good enough anyway. We need the blood. This isn't like any other chem. When you dance with the devil, you either keep dancing or you get burnt to a crisp. Oh. Oh, my darling girl.
Say, you don't happen to be on good terms with the refuge, do you?
Must have left something. Did I screw up?
Well then, how much of a people person are you? I need to ask you something crazy. Because you don't really know us, and really, from what you've seen so far, have no reason to trust us. But my sister is in trouble, so I'm going to ask. Could you fly to Atlantic City and bring back a dose of Devil's Blood?
You make the second part of that sound like a simple ask.
I did say it was crazy, but please, and I really mean it, it'd be a bad idea for any of us to go back there right now.
So cold.
If newcomers like us could even negotiate a flight in the first place. Remember the firefight earlier? Whoever sent those people still has it out for us.
For one of us, in any case.
Undetermined. We could fight about it all day. It's an exclusive chem, typically only accessible to high society and to the people that source it. The mob. You'll have to find one of them. See what you can negotiate. You're not joking, right? Oh, you can pull this off. Abby needs you too. Please, just let us know as soon as possible if anything goes wrong. I'll do whatever I can for her in the meantime.
So cold. The Russo's little helper. Be a dear and remind me the world already ended. Please. No shopping for miles. Not even a convenience store. And the way these Appalachians decorate their vending machines.